here. We're going to talk about some different ways to style Salomon. It's one of the new brands that we have in here at Canoe Club, and that's definitely one of our favorites as far as shoe wear goes. And there's a lot of different ways you can wear those shoes. I think traditionally, you know, being here in Boulder, Colorado, they've been worn more for the functionality. They've, you know, our parents and parents' parents have been wearing Salomon. They've been around for a while, but there's definitely some different ways to wear them. So we're gonna talk about those a few different ways. And to start us off, we're gonna go with maybe the least worn sort of way, which is trying to make it a bit more formal. So here what we have are the XT6s. These are going to be in this nice like white ivory colorway with a little bit of like cream on the bottom, and then this really light orange, a really pretty shoe. I have this pair myself. This was the one that I picked up from the shop. First of all, first things first, these shoes are incredibly comfortable. I'd never worn a Salomon shoe in my entire life, and putting it on, they certainly are made with the intention of being worn and worn well, and then I think those style elements come after that. So it's extremely wearable and extremely comfortable right off the bat. Secondly, you know, with this being a white shoe, it's going to be, maybe more favorable for the spring and summer, just because of the colors you're working with and not wanting to get them too dirty. So that's the shoe we are starting off the formal outfit with. And then on the bottom, so my thinking was, you know, with a shoe like this, a lot of suiting is going to maybe be a little strange just as far as fabric goes, because this is such a it's very tactical looking, and the materials are very tactical. So I was trying to think about what could be used to complement that and work well with that. We have these Lady White, they're like a trouser, but more, they're like a cinched waist, a sweatband waist, and they have a bit of a sheen to them. So I think that that kind of ties those two things in together. I think if you were to go with, you know, maybe some sort of patterned cotton twill pant, the difference in fabrics might be a little jarring. Definitely workable, nothing wrong with that, but I wanted to try to play with some materials that lent themselves to that tactical look while still being a bit more formal. So these Lady White pants that we have here, really, really comfortable, a great color as well, and for spring and summer especially, very versatile. So we have those pants with those shoes. Again, you get a little bit of this color in that sort of like, it's like an eggnog almost, the color. And then on top, with it being so in Boulder right now, it's like 100 degrees. It's very hot. There's more pollen in the air than there's ever been. Not that this matters, but the allergies have been tough recently. So trying to be cool and stay light during the season, I think, is super important. So, and again, this is a shirt that everybody should consider purchasing. I think having like a really clean Oxford is not only useful for events where you need to be kind of in the box and put kind of normally, but also like it can be styled in so many different ways where you can dress it up and dress it down. And so I really like having a blue Oxford in my rotation for shirts. So this one is the one we did with Corridor. And super basic, super simple. I went with a large in the pant to kind of give me a more billowing effect and make it a little looser. I'm usually like a medium. I think I did that. Did I do that? Nope. I wanted the medium. True to size. So I didn't do that. They're going to be a bit more billowing anyways because of the cut, but I went with a medium on the shirt for sure because, again, you know, trying to keep it a bit more formal usually means also keeping to your dimensions rather than playing with sizing. Trying to stick to true to size can make you look a little bit cleaner cut. So we went with that on top. I'm hoping that the nice blues in this play well with the creams and that kind of eggnog in this like peach color, which is really pretty. So that's our attempt at doing Salomon formally. I really think it's an exciting way to wear these shoes. Personally, I'd like to figure out more ways to do that because although I live in Boulder, I'm actually from Boulder, I don't do a lot of outdoor activity as you might expect. So these shoes will, as much as they're worn out in the mountains, be shoes that I try to style here in our quaint little town of Boulder as well. So this is a way that you could maybe wear them on a summer evening or something like that. So that's our first outfit. we're gonna see what it looks like on, and we'll do the next two soon. All right, everyone, so that was the first look that we just saw. The second one, we're going to do a more casual version of styling these shoes. The shoe that we have here, I believe, is the X, the Wings X2, something like that. Is that right? XT Wings 2, that's the name of the shoe. It's in this kind of, what color is this? This is like a bit of an olive, or it's actually a little bit lighter than that, almost like a pea green with then this black topping and a little bit of this kind of lavender color in the heel. Really pretty. Again, I think the nice thing about the shoes that we have in from Salomon right now is they all have like these just very wonderful colors to them. A lot of the shoes I see them making, a lot of stores are picking up just like the all whites or the all blacks versions. And I like that we have some playfulness as far as color goes in these shoes because it's a fun way to wear them. So starting off with this, we'll go with the bottom first. These are these Capital sweat shorts. Again, it has this green pattern throughout, and then the material is like a terry cloth. These are gonna be a size 3, so they're gonna be a little bit big for me. We're running low on some of our Capital stuff. We're reaching the end of the season, so we went with those though. I think they have a bit of a, you know, a cinching at the waist, so I should be able to tie those and kind of create a bit of an oversized look with them, which I think is fun for the summer. So yeah, that's the short that we're gonna pair with it. My thinking behind that is that the green from the short will work somewhat well with the green in the shoes. This would be an example though of like on the last one, we were kind of talking about how the fabrics are kind of trying to stay in a similar lane, and then this would be something where we're having really natural looking fabrics. I mean, both of these are something that would remind me of like being at the beach, which I would like to be at the beach right now. That'd be great. But instead we're here. And so this though is going to be like as far away from the beach as possible as far as what you're thinking about in my mind. So I'm interested to see where these two things come together, if they work, if they don't. I think they will, but I guess we'll see when it's on. And so, yeah, so those are the shorts. And then up top, we're gonna do this Henley from Velvachine. It's in this really light yellow color. I think it'll be really pretty with the greens. And again, keeping with the casual nature of the outfit, I didn't want to do anything more formal or anything more complicated than just a shirt. So I think this color will work really well with the greens. And yeah, it's a really pretty Henley as well. I have a friend who only wears Henley shirts. So if Vito, you end up watching this, this is for you, Vito. So this is the Henley. And we're gonna go from there to the hat, which is by Kabalami. And yeah. And this is in a camo colorway. That's more of like a sand camo without any sort of dark greens. It's more of these beiges and browns. Again, I think it'll work well with the kind of almost beige gray undertone in the shoe and corresponding beige gray undertones in those shorts. So trying to make these colors work together, you got the gray or the yellow and the green. I think it'll be a really cute outfit, hopefully, especially for this time of the year. And yeah, this is something that you could definitely use these shoes more for what they're meant to be used as, which is something to go hiking, go for long walks, and kind of use the functionality of them more. So yeah, we're gonna try that one on and see how it goes. So here we go. Okay, so now the last outfit is going to be a very tactical one. We have on bottom for these ones, these are the XA Pro 1 from Salomon. I think that these might be the coolest of them all. They have this, it looks very 90s to me. They have this really cool purple zigzag going across the shoe, and then this sort of neon neon-y looking yellow, almost like a light green on the side. So that's the shoe that we're going with. Again, all of the shoes we've shown so far have this pull tab. So like, for functionality and like ease of wear, you just slip your foot in and then you just cinch it closed, which, you know, more shoe companies should do that. That's like the nicest thing about the shoe, honestly, is not having to tie your shoes, especially if you don't know how to tie your shoes. These are the shoes you want. So hopefully you know how to tie your shoes. And then on the bottom, we're gonna do these Gore-Tex Bybori pants. We got a few different styles of Byborian right now, shirts and pants wise. These are going to be the only one that they have Gore-Tex in. So again, on the front is like this ripstop in a like nice light blue. And then on the back, you'll see in the video, but it's like a quilted pattern look to it. Really complex in its appearance. We actually have a customer who probably has one of the more unique senses of style that comes into the shop, and he picked up the full suit. There's like a jacket that comes with this as well. And he's like a little bit older gentleman, really, really cool. He wears like a bunch of different like Prada bags, and he has like a, he's just an interesting guy, honestly. And he bought the full fit and he wears it around Boulder, and it's really cool. And so this is kind of an ode to him, because I think that these don't get enough love. And although they are expensive, I don't think that there's anything else that we carry that even comes close to what it does in presentation. So we're gonna go with those. On the bottom, you can't see it, I think, on the video, but there's also some cinches where the leg ends, so you can play with the dimensions of the pant as well. So I think it'll look nice, the colors with the purple and a little bit of gray throughout the shoe, I think will complement the gray in the pants as well. And then speaking of gray, we have the Bybora shirt. I went with the large in this. I'm sticking with the medium in the pants, so that's true to size. And then in the shirt, I'm going with a large because I want it to be a little bit oversized. These pants are gonna be a bit wider cut, so I could have gone with the medium, but I think that would have made the proportions a little out of whack. So we're gonna play with the large in that. And again, this is just a really breathable and I think it's just a cool shirt. I like it. So we're gonna do that with that. And then on top, we're doing this lady white cap. Oh, no fall, nice. So we're gonna do that lady white cap, beige color. I think we'll tie in the grays, hopefully. Might also take it off my head. I'm not a huge hat person in general, but we have some good hats, so I'm gonna give them a try. And yeah, so that's this outfit. You know, this is one where I think a lot of people are styling Solomon more tactically, like almost, you could even say it's like streetwear-esque. So yeah, I think this is just our take on doing that. I'm excited to wear it. This isn't something I would ever typically wear. I might wear these by themselves, this shirt by themselves, and the shoes by themselves, but I'm not much of a tactical clothing aficionado, nor am I an owner of many tactical gear pieces of clothing. So I'm gonna see what it looks like on, see how I like it, and yeah, you'll see what it looks like as well. So those are the outfits that we chose. We have the formal one, we have the more casual, and then we have this more streetwear tactical version as well. So yeah, that's what we've put together. You know, there's a lot of different ways you could style these shoes. We wanted to just show them in a few different lights because of the sort of specificity of the shoe, like what it was originally intended to do, which was to just be functional and used as a shoe where people run and hike and climb with. And I know that Solomon's getting popular because they're being used more in fashion, but yeah, it doesn't necessarily mean it makes it any easier for the normal person to wear them fashionably. So we're hoping that this kind of helps out. And yeah, if you guys have any comments about things that we showed in the video, any questions about other sorts of styling tips that you may have questions on, let us know in the comments. And yeah, give us a like and subscribe if you aren't enjoying the content we're putting out. Let us know if there's anything else that you're looking to see. And from all of us over here at Canoe Club, it's about probably 90 degrees outside in Boulder, Colorado. It's beautiful. Like I said, the pollen is kind of intense, but we're okay with it because it's a gorgeous day here. So yeah, thanks for watching, and we will see you guys next time.